I'm a big fan of B.
B? Just
yeah, no, B's cool. No, I do like B, I just think like G is kind of... G's a very versatile note, because you can... I don't know, you can put it on anything and it'll sound cool, like it's... Like, you could play that note anywhere and it would sound great.
Yeah.
I mean, you could play it with the B and...
Yeah. A lot of my favourite bands use G's and B's.
Do they? So. Yeah, I think mine do. I think that's where it comes from. I mean, it might be, like, inbuilt. It might be, like, this kind of genetic thing you grew up with where you just kind of... You've got, like, a fondness for different notes. And I think, with me, it's G. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I can't explain it.
Well, I'm scared. I'm a bit scared of wasps, so maybe I like B's more.
I'm Tom from the band Los Campesinos.
Hi, I'm Neil from the band Los Campesinos as well.
And today we're going to show you how to play the hit song, Songs About Your Girlfriend. So grab your axe and get ready to play some rocking riffs and hot licks. The first thing you'll need to know is about vibes. What I mean by vibes is... that indefinable thing, it's that special bit of magic that you can't put your finger on.
You can't put your finger on my vibes.
If you look up the word vibe in the dictionary, all you'll see is a question mark. You can't define it. The good thing about vibes though, is that if you can capture the right vibe, you don't need to know what notes you're playing, or what order they go in. You don't even need to know what instrument you're playing. Watch. Grab some buds.
Yeah, grab some buds.
Okay, so this song, forget about the vibes. We're going to need to know what notes we're playing. Now this song is in A major.
That's a good key.
It's a great key. Now, A major was the first ever key invented, so they named it after the first letter of the alphabet. The major part came later because it was a very important key. It's the first best key. Okay, so this riff, it starts off, leave the open A string ringing, like that. We're gonna play a bunch of notes. I'm not gonna tell you every note, but it's... Starting with the A, down to the F sharp, C sharp, lots of notes, just watch my fingers. Now watch the fingers carefully here, because they're gonna go really fast, they're like lightning, and just watch them. The riff.
That sounds great.
It does sound great. That's all you need. Just lots of notes, lots of rhythm. Great riff.
Tom, what inspired this song? Could you talk to us about that?
Well, I mean, I guess specifically with the music, I was thinking a lot about the state of the world and I mean, just how bad things have gotten. I was thinking about kind of war and famine and teenage pregnancy, and I wanted to try and capture the emotion of how I felt thinking about those things.
Yeah.
And so I thought, well, I feel kind of happy, so I played an A major chord. That's quite a happy chord. And then I thought a bit more about how bad things were getting, and so I played an E major chord. And then I just felt really sad thinking about starving kids and people, you know, and so I played F sharp minor chord, because that's a very sad sort of depressed chord, and that transition from A major to F sharp minor, I think that really captures the sadness of famine. You do not like us 'cause your girlfriend likely does, and all your friends agree. Okay, so that's the main riff to get things going. You play that twice, and everyone's thinking, yeah, that's a pretty cool riff. These guys can really play. But there's not much really happening. It lures you in. It's just the guitar, and then before you know it, wham.
Wham.
The bass comes in, the drums come in, and then, most importantly, the vox.
Vox.
Now, what I mean by vox is singing with the voice. It's not a term that's widely used. You might not understand what I mean when I say the word vox, because there's a lot of lingo in the music industry that you don't necessarily know about. But vox is singing with your voice. It's the most important part of a pop song. There's something very special about the voice that our ears have been tuned to since we were amoebas and monkeys. And there's just a special something about it. And forget about the vox, we're going to play the riff. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we've made it to the pre-chorus.
That's the bit before the chorus.
Yeah, and it's called that because pre is from the Latin for before the chorus. So pre-chorus means before the chorus, chorus. Before the chorus, chorus.
The chorus before the chorus.
Anyway, this is the riff. Anyway, so you're playing that riff, and you just keep playing that riff, and the bass note underneath changes, so you're going from A, down to E, F sharp, back to E. Watch. 1, 2, 3, 4. To play because you're doing the bass note with your thumb, but we're advanced creatures. We can use our opposable digits. You can play it with your dick for all I care.
You have to tap into a special place. You have to look a bit harder into yourself and you have to go places you wouldn't necessarily normally go. And I mean, I don't mean physically. I mean, it's not about kind of sticking a finger in your ear hole or up your bum. It's kind of, I mean, in the mental sense, and not like mental, like stuff to do with your brain, because I mean, there are a lot of dark things in there, and there are a lot of things you don't necessarily want to admit to yourself, but you have to get those things out. I think it's a form of catharsis to get those out, and it's like that F sharp minor chord I was talking about before. That's a dark, heavy, disgusting chord, and everyone's got those F sharp minors inside of them, and you just have to get them out somehow.
Like, it sounds like us, doesn't it?
Yeah, people hear that and they think Los Campesinos, and I think if we make a minor, then it just completely changes everything.
I can feel myself changing.
What, as you play it?
I think so.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I mean. Like, I think it will have that effect on people.
It makes you feel a bit weird.
Yeah, because it's powerful, isn't it? I mean,
it's only what, just done a song, which is just...
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Songs that I've written about your girlfriend are just songs of spices you came to earn, and cause I never... Okay, so you're playing. The drums are drumming, they're doing a bit on the metal drums, a bit on the tom-toms. Now it's time for the chorus.
This is the big bit.
This is it. This is the chorus. This is the bit where Gareth sings the title, so you know it's a very important bit. This is where the one-noted piano comes in, and it's just doing one note. It's very dramatic. This is a very dramatic song, and drama is built on one-noted notes.
All you need is one note.
Sometimes all you need is one note. I personally think that they should build one-noted pianos, and then... you can just buy whichever note you need, and you can take that around with you. And anyway, okay. So this is the chorus riff. I'm gonna put my distortion pedal on because it makes it more exciting. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you.
that's it. That's all you need for this song.
It's a great song.
It's a really great song. And for the second half, just repeat it.
Yeah, just repeat it.
Kids love that shit. Just repeat it. So there you have it. Now you know all of our secrets.
Don't tell anyone.
Don't tell anyone our secrets. We've been Los Campesinos. We've been the guitar players from Los Campesinos. Stay groovy and keep vibing. Songs I've written about your girlfriend are just songs of spices you came to earn. And all the songs I've written about your girlfriend are just feeling sad when my heart is on the nerve. Cause I never made a smile like that. And she never made me smile right back. Although I always made her purr like a cat. She said I never made a smile like that.
Really good.
Yeah. This bitch even wants, like, she's texting me all the time.
Got that problem all the time.
Have you?
Fucking Chuck, mate, fucking Chuck.
Fucking Chuck?
Hmm. So I will.
Like stuff at them?
Well, yeah, if you want. Ha 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 ha.